In this video, I'm going to show you how we can hide keyboard programmatically. Sometimes we need to hide a keyboard programmatically when our user is done with inputting the data, or when we want to execute something that we will not need to the keyboard to be displayed. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can manually hide the keyboard using the code. So I've created here an input, and then I've created here a button. So this input will help us to execute, to unhide the keyboard, and this button will do what? Will hide the keyboard. So I've given this button a name called keyboard. I've given it an ID called keyboard, and then I've come here in the main activity and create this button. I give it a what? The name keyboard. Then I created this keyboard. I found this keyboard by using find view ID by ID. So to attach this keyboard or to bind the keyboard to this, it's with its object. Then after I created a click listener, as how we always do it, set on click listener, and then on click I call the what? The hide keyboard method. So here on the hide keyboard method, I give it you have an input. We create an input manager object, which is I can call it IMM or anything that you want. So input manager, and then I say, or to create this one, we just simply say this dot get system service, and then we type cast it to input manager, and then we put dot input method service. So this input method service from activity dot input method service is the one that is going to initialize for us the input method object. Then after, we have to check if there is any view that is being currently forecast on by simply saying view is equal to this dot get current forecast. So this one will help to search across the whole application which view is having the current focus. So if there is any, this view will be stored here. If there is no any, or if it got null, it means that there is no any view. I'll create just my temporary view to make sure that there is a this view is not what? Is not null. Then after, I'll use this input method manager to hide the keyboard by simply saying IMM, or the object that I created here, dot hide soft input from window, and then I put the view that I got from here, which is having the current focus if it is there, and then I say dot get window token. So when to get the window token, and then I pass the flag of zero. So this flag of zero, it will do what? It will hide the keyboard if it is currently showing on the screen. So let's execute the application and see what it means. So it will start executing, and it will install our application, and then we'll go to our emulator, and we see how we can hide the keyboard programmatically. So I'll expand the keyboard by simply focusing at the input here. So you see, I have the keyboard there. Even though I click anywhere, this keyboard won't be hidden. You see, I cannot hide the keyboard. But let us click here, so that you should call this method of hide keyboard, and then our keyboard is hidden. So we focus again, we have the keyboard. We focus, we have the keyboard. So that's how we can hide the keyboard from the screen. Thank you for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel. In the next video, we are going to start Android User Interface Challenge. It's going to be a series of videos where we're going to practice different range of user interfaces, and I hope you will be part of the challenge. Every week we'll be producing a series of videos that will be helping us to learn or to challenge ourselves how we can improve our user interfaces in the Android development using Material UI of Google. I hope you won't be that part of series, and if you want to be part of it, make sure that you subscribe, activate that notification button, that you should always be among the people who will be getting the notification when I upload videos. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.